A new way to see the history of Santa Monica right where it took place.
This guy, Rich DeMuro, here to explain in today's Tech Smart. Good morning.
Hey, good morning to you guys. Happy Monday. We're going to be hearing a lot more about augmented reality, virtual reality as that Apple headset comes along. But let's talk Snapchat. They are already a leader in augmented reality. And while their silly lenses are popular, today they're launching a more serious feature. It's an augmented reality walking tour that brings a bit of Santa Monica history to life in honor of Juneteenth.
So we've crossed the street, and what are we coming up to now?
So currently, it's Herman's Auto Body, but it used to be Juanita's Beauty Shop.
Imagine a walking tour where the buildings you're looking at come to life.
So this was a major kind of hangout area, and then it also was the meat market for the community.
Jason Crockett is with Snapchat. He's showing me a new augmented reality experience called Broadway to Freeway. It tells the story of a thriving community of color in Santa Monica before a freeway development erased it.
We think it's critical because so many people don't know the history of their own local communities.
To access the tour, you scan a QR code or open the Snapchat app and look for the lens, which is being released to honor Juneteenth.
We felt it was the right time to partner with the city and other stakeholders like Calvary Baptist Church to be able to elevate this story in a moment of celebration and jubilee.
The tour has several stops on a map. You look through your phone to bring the history of the area to life with audio, photos, and more.
Over here to the east is Calvary Baptist Church.
It's so exciting to be able to take our exhibition outside of the museum and place it where it actually happened.
Snapchat partnering with the Quinn Research Center to create the exhibit.
The Quinn Research Center exists to study Black family history and culture in the Santa Monica Bay Area.
And so we're hearing audio, we're seeing the church in real life, but also some overlays to give us a sense of maybe the past.
Walking around, it's easy to get immersed in the rich history and story of the world around you.
That's the important part of the story that we really want to make sure people grasp is the dislocation piece.
Although this specific tour was commissioned by Snapchat, anyone has the ability to create something similar for their neighborhood.
AR is probably like one of the best tools that we probably have for learning right now. I think it's an untapped tool that we'll probably make more use of in the future.
Courtney Taylor is an AR developer that worked on some of the visuals for the tour.
You're walking past this building that you never would have, you know, thought twice about. And now that you understand, you know the history of this building, you can empathize with, like, you know, the people who live in this community.
Now, the tool developers use to create this type of experience is called the Snap Lens Studio. And like I said earlier, it's probably only going to get more popular thanks to Apple's efforts with their upcoming virtual reality headset. All right, I'm going to put a link to the tour on my website. Just go to richontech.tv if you want to check it out. Snap has done location-based things before.
Sure.
This is the first time they've linked an experience to a walking tour via GPS. And I think it's an idea that really could take off.
Absolutely. All right. Thank you so much, Rich.